Good morning student. Today I am going to explain disability issues while teaching and using computer. Increased focus on inclusive education and promoting access for the student with disability and impairment in the field of the technology and the computer science have made today classroom really diverse and inclusive. Students, we are already knowing many students are not able to learn the computer which are suffering from disability. For example, there are many disability issues like locomotor disability, severe deformities, polio, leprosy, cerebral palsy, hearing and speech disability, hearing impairment, speech aphasia, cognitive impairment, specific learning deficit, and next is vision impairment, low vision or blindness. The student, these are the issues while learning computer. How can we remove these disabilities? So this is not possible, but we have to provide advanced information technology to learning this type of the students so that this student also learn and do the other works in the computer fields. First of all, unavailability of the teaching material. The students, in these methods we have to provide advanced technology so that the student can easily use study materials and do the work on the computer. So for this we have to provide sophisticated virtual keyboard software, a joystick that is the specific to needs of the child, a programming editor that can be interfaced with the virtual keyboard and doesn't require any mouse movements. So in this way these students can also operate the computer. And for low vision students, Braille keyboards, Braille monitor and the Braille printers. Student, these are the special equipment of the computer used for these disabled students. Lack of special need teachers. Student, today government is providing the training for the teacher so that teacher will assist such type of the students. There should be teacher who know what types of the hardware, software, tools, etc. can be used for differently able student as per their specific need. A special type of specialized hardware such as Braille keyboards, monitor, printer, synthetic speech generator and Google Assistant. There are many types of the software features and the voice assistant that visually impaired students. Microsoft Narrator and Cortana and Ubuntu, Orca and Onboards. The voice assistant which blind people can use for a variety of the essential tasks. A special version of Linux called B-Linux, especially meant for the blind. Host of accessibility features of the various office software that can be easily activated. A specialized editor for visually impaired students for typing the program. Next is lack of supporting curriculum. A student, curriculum should be designed while keeping focus on inclusive education. There always should be possible alternative, keeping in the mind special need of the students. The software and the program should be used so that disabled student can easily work on that. For example, Office software based curriculum can easily be implemented for all types of the student, as nearly all Office software provides accessibility feature. In the programming language, we can also provide in Python programming language and Scratch. In the class 10 syllabus, we are providing programming for only for disabled students and Scratch for all type of the students. Possible solution for disability issues are straightforward. School must work towards making available the required teaching aid material to fulfill special need of the student with disability. School must employ special need teachers, means a teacher who have completed the training for teaching such type of student, means disabled students, because these teachers very very well educated to deal such type of the students. School must support the inclusive curriculum and refrain from any other practice that directly or indirectly put the disabled student at disadvantage side. Role of new media in the society. We are surrounded and influenced by media like never before. This has happened quietly, repeatedly in last 10 to 20 years compared to earlier years. Earlier, the role of the media involved the latest and the current news, some gossip and happening taking place. But this times, media has advanced features. So there are many features developed in the social media. First, online campaign. The student and the online campaign is planned, set up the activities carried online for the goal or the purpose. Means we have a lot of option for campaigning anything online. Today we are using social networking websites for campaigning anything. Suppose that you are realizing these things is not happening in our society, then you can campaign these things online. You can post your opinion and the view on the WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram and other social networking sites. This is the simple advertisements and the ads you can post. Next topic is crowdsourcing. A resource is the source or the supply from which some types of the benefit is reaped. You have read so much about resource, from traditional resource to modern age has made available resources in unconventional form. For example, if used properly, population can be very good resource. The same applies to modern age social media. Crowdsourcing refers to the practice of obtaining the contribution from crowd in the form of needed service, idea, or content mainly from online community. Crowdsourcing can give organization different idea and the solution through and the organization crowdsourcing campaign. The user and the individual collectively contribute to the design idea or the product launch. For example, McDonald's burger builder asks for and the idea of the burger as per your taste from it the customer. So student, in this way we can also take idea and the other things from the users by online. So this type of the resource is known as online resourcing. Crowdsourcing can be applied for the various tasks and the various purposes, such as designing new products, updating design feature of the product, crowd voting, crowdfunding, creating tasks such as collective writing or moving, feedback. Suppose that we are going to implement any things, but implementing that things and that things is the essential for society or not. So for this we can also take the feedback from our users and the audience. Benefit of crowdsourcing include accelerated collaborative innovation, sharing of ideas, co-creation, engagement of important stakeholders such as consumer or citizen, cost saving, increase efficiency. Smart mobs. Next topic is smart mob. A smart mob is organized group of the people who have gathered through the use of social media to protest or lobby for publicized social or political cause. Like a using social media, anyone can organize a smart mob by deciding about the goal or the issue, deciding about the event size, place, date and time, forming a short digital message information people about it, and finally sending this message through the use of social media to target the group of people. The connectivity, networking and the reach of the social media will ensure that the message reaches to maximum people, which can come and be part of your smart mob of designated date and the times. Issues with the internet. So students, there are many issues regarding to internet. First is internet as and the echo chambers. Students, we are already knowing echo means repetitions. So here the term echo generally means repeated sound of the original sound coming back to the origin. The term echo chamber roughly means listening or reading or viewing something that reflect your view. The term internet as echo chamber has become a discussion topic increasingly in the past few years. Filtering and matching of the content being displayed and delivered on internet as per the reader personal interest, view and liking is known as internet as echo chambers. Do you know why this happened? This happened because Google shows the search result to each of them as per their personal views, interest and liking. Such a behavior of the website and the web application is often referred to as internet as the echo chamber. As internet echoes your own views and interests and not to real picture. The echo effect has become a common thing on the internet, where the user reader are shown only the content that fit into the domain of their current political or the social view. This way, the content they get to the read on the internet is never challenging or thought-provoking for them. Instead, it just reinforces their beliefs. And student, special note, echo effect on the internet create personalized online words which may narrowing the reader minds and which prevent reader from seeing the real picture or the real scenario which is their right, but they are deprived of it. Next topic is net neutrality. The students, you are realizing we are not using internet as the equal manners. Suppose that if we are using internets, then there is no issue regarding some websites, but some websites are not opening properly at the same speed. Such type of the problem is known as net neutrality. The one possible reason could be that your ISP is not exercising net neutrality. Do you what net neutrality means? Well, net neutrality is the principle to ensure that ISP is not biased towards some sites while other sites get stepmotherly treatments. Why is your ISP behaving this way? Why is it giving preference to some site content over others? You must be pondering, no. And you dig deeper, you get to know that preferred sites and your ISP both have the same owners. So your ISP wants that its owner site should get preferential treatment over other and other sites. That's why there is no problem to that particular sites, but if the owners not belongs for particular websites or other websites, so they are not giving ISP net speed to the that particular websites. That's why that website is not working properly. Principle of net neutrality. First, no blocking. Your internet access provider can't block you from accessing legal content of your choice. No throttling. Your ISP can't intentionally throttle legal internet traffic to the slower speeds than other traffic. No paid prioritizations. Your ISP can't sell fast lane service to content provider who can pay more than others. Next is internet addiction. When a person can't find a balance between their time online and their time offline, it considerably affects their mental health. This condition is called internet addiction or internet addiction disorders. So students, if a student is excessive use the internet, so this type of addiction is known as internet addiction. In the internet addiction disorder, playing online games, compulsive watching of internet video and pornography, accessing online shopping, compulsive online gaming, accessing blogging and accessing social networking. If we are doing, this is internet addiction disorder. How to overcome the internet addiction? When a person is trying to come out on the internet addiction, he or she may experience withdrawal symptom like mental and emotional symptom like anger, depression, relief, mood swings, anxiety, fear, physical symptom and upset stomach, eating irregularities such as skipping meals, severe headache, back chest, dry eye, ignoring personal hygiene. Thus, for internet addiction, a person needs timely help of qualified doctor, counselor, and a family so that that person can overcome from these problems. Students, there are many case study, but I am going to explain only one case study. And I am giving as the homework to complete other case study. First, case study 2. Students, WikiLeaks is a non-profit organization funded by and the Australian Julian Assange in the 2006, which published secret and the leaked document. It published confidential document of importance such as government files, which are somehow obtained through anonymous source. Its website says WikiLeaks will accept restricted or censored material of the political, ethical, diplomatic or historical significance. We don't accept rumor, opinion and other kinds of the first-hand accounts or material that is publicly available elsewhere. WikiLeaks has released many confidential documents such as diplomatic cables relating to US activities in the Syria, document about the wars in the Iraq and the Afghanistan, and secret files about prisoners in Guantanamo Bay Detention Center. Again, the reason behind the existence and the source of WikiLeaks can be easily attributed to the internet. Through internet only, WikiLeaks is able to release the confidential document and the diplomatic cables. So student, this is the media and this is the source of internets where we can release anything, but we have to leak anything. We have to collect evidence so that we can prove our secret messaging. So my dear student, complete other case study, and we have completed this chapter. From the next day I will start next chapter, means its next unit. Bye and thank